Welcome back to Whisper Gaming ASMR. Today we're going to be playing some more Minecraft. And it's been a few days since I last played. Actually, probably closer to a week. I was taking a little break from playing Minecraft and recorded a few Deep Rock Galactic videos. They might already be on my channel, they might not. Not sure what order I'm going to upload these in, but anyway, we're getting back to Minecraft today, and I do remember in the last video, I had scoped out a cave and was planning to explore it, so I think that's what we will do in today's video. I don't have a ton of resources. I don't know how much of this I need to actually bring. Guess I'll leave the pork chops so I don't take up too much of my inventory. I probably don't need those wooden planks, but I'm going to take them just in case. And I'm going to make some more torches quickly before we leave. It's also a bit of a loud morning here in New York City, so hopefully this recording goes okay. Just had a trash truck go by, which was pretty loud, and someone was honking at them, which also was loud. Okay, maybe I'll make one more shovel. Okay, have a decent amount of inventory space, and we can always drop stuff if we need to. Probably don't need that much cobblestone either, but you never know. I wish I had a map. I would like to make a map so I can keep track of where I am. Oh, I do have paper, but I think I need a compass in order to make a map. Which, do I have any iron? Let's see, I can't even remember what's in all these. Furnaces. That's the thing. I'm recording quite a few games on this channel. So that means every now and then there's quite a gap between when I play a game, so I kind of forget. I need to start making notes so I can remember. Okay, does this have a recipe for a compass? I can't remember. Does a compass require redstone? I'm missing something that I need for a compass. Again, someone recently asked me in the comments of one of my Minecraft videos if I was a noob. I don't think they were being mean. If they were, I didn't take it as an insult. But I am definitely... Oh, it's also dead at night. I am definitely a noob when it comes to Minecraft now. I've explained in other videos, I started playing Minecraft when it first came out in 2009, and probably maybe 2014 at the latest was the last time I actually played Minecraft. I don't want to say seriously, but the last time I probably played Minecraft and wouldn't have been considered a noob and actually kind of knew what I was doing. So, I just realized 2014 was almost a decade ago, which makes me feel old. But yes, I am definitely a Minecraft noob. Sorry, I forgot how my base is laid out. I also didn't have time to get it all set up this morning, but I'm currently recording Minecraft on my MacBook, which is why my frames aren't great. Because I'm also have OBS running in the background, but I think this weekend I will set up Minecraft on my desktop and see if I can get a little better frame rate and potentially use some of the shaders which make the game look better. But yeah, also have had suggestions to play Grand Theft Auto 5 online. I did just buy Grand Theft Auto on sale, on the Steam sale, so I have that now. I bought it a long time ago through the Rockstar launcher, and there's either some issues with it or I forgot my login or something, so I just rebought it through Steam. I've never played Grand Theft Auto online before. I've just played the single player version a little bit again. Probably played that. The last time I really played that was in 2015 or 2016, whenever that came out. These games are making me feel very old now that I'm realizing it was close to 10 years ago that I played most of them, but I am planning on doing at least one Grand Theft Auto online video with, I think it was suggested to do a hard candy, so I do plan on doing that. It's on my to-do list. Might be a little bit because I think I still have at least 7 or 8 videos that I already have recorded to upload. I have some more Minecraft. No, not more Minecraft. That's why I'm recording this one. I have, I think, 3 more Metroid videos coming that are recorded. I have a few Stardew Valley videos that are recorded. And then I have 3 Deep Rock Galactic videos that I recorded, so. And I still want to get back to the Slime Rancher as well. I mentioned this in a different video, but I had 5 hours of videos recorded that the settings got messed up in OBS. So when I record these, I typically have it on 5 different audio channels. So I have the game audio and microphone and all the different things on different audio channels, so I can adjust the levels later and take out the game audio, because I know some people prefer to listen with audio and some people prefer without. So anyway, they're on different channels. So I recorded an hour-long Minecraft video with Hard Candy, which I think was really good. And then I recorded 2 half-an-hour Minecraft videos and an hour-long Slime Rancher video. And then 2 Deep Rock Galactic videos that were, I think one was an hour and another was 45 minutes. And I should have been checking them as I was recording them, because after I finished recording all those, I found out everything was on one audio channel and the levels were all messed up and I couldn't adjust them, so 5 hours of recording went to waste, unfortunately, and those videos will never see the light of day. So I do want to go back and re-record Slime Rancher, because I think that'd be a good video, a good game for this channel. And, I just realized that the video where I found this cave and did all that stuff was the ones that were messed up, so, yeah, in those videos I went and scouted out some caves. And, that's what we'll be exploring today. So this is one of them. I think there's another cave I found, too, that looked a little better to explore. But enough about channel stuff. I feel like that's boring to talk about. My personal life. I'm very into playing music. This past year or so, I've got really into music, and I just signed up for a singing class that I started last night, which I really enjoyed. It's at this music school in Brooklyn called the Jalopy School of Music, and I've been interested in it for a while, but I always miss the sign-up dates. Always missed the sign-up dates for classes, but I finally found the list of classes before they started. Usually I find it when it's midway through the semester. So I sign up for, oh crap, oh boy, guitars. Three of them. Enjoying it so far. The teacher seems really nice. She's a really good singer. And it's with about 13 other students, or maybe 12 other. I think there might be 13 of us in total. And just learning kind of how to feel your voice and your body, hence the embodied voices name of the class. And just like singing together in groups, and it's like very, I don't want to say non-threatening, that's not the word, but it's very beginner friendly, which I've been trying to teach myself to sing for about a year now. So I'm definitely a lot better than I was a year ago, but I'd still consider myself a beginner, as I haven't really had any formal training. And yeah, it's very inclusive and a fun collaborative environment. And I'm excited for it. I think it's an 8-week class, but I'm going to unfortunately miss the final class because I'm going on a trip with my girlfriend, and we leave the day of the last class meeting. But I'm excited for the next 6 weeks of the class. And then I also have been looking at getting a 12-string guitar for quite a while now, and last week, I hope that bird chirping isn't too loud, last week this website called Musician's Friend, which sells musical instruments and things like that, every day they have, every day they have something called the Stupid Deal of the Day, which I get email notifications for, and Wednesday, I got a notification that they had a 12-string guitar on sale, and it was like almost half off. It was usually a $700 guitar, and it was on sale for $449. So that seemed like a pretty good deal. So I ended up buying that, and it just came in the mail yesterday, right before I had to leave for my class, so I haven't had much time to play it, but I'm excited to learn 12-string guitar. So that's what's going on in my personal life. Also had a bit of a crazy weekend. My girlfriend and her twin sister ran the New York City Half Marathon this weekend, so her family and one of their friends and her sister's boyfriend and everything stayed at our apartment, so we had four people staying with us. It was a bit of a madhouse, but it was a fun weekend, and they both did really good in the marathon, so I was proud of them for that. And but I'm a bit of an introvert. Oh, I hear a spider. And definitely need my alone time, so I am excited to have the apartment back to ourselves this week. And, oh crap. Oh, how did that happen? Oh, is that when I hit zero? What button switch those things. And my job is also going pretty well this month. I'm in sales, so each month is a bit of a roller coaster, and the past few months have been a little rough, but this month is going pretty well, so also happy about that. And also found out that I wasn't doing the best the past couple months, which has been stressful because I've been working harder than ever, which I'm pretty sure, at least when I do sales, I feel like the harder I work, the worse I'm doing. In the months that I do really well, I don't feel like I'm working that hard. But I found out there was a error in our system the past few months that was affecting me more than anyone else on the team. So a lot of my poor performance was not actually my fault. So that made me feel a little better. But at the same time, my company hasn't made it clear if they're going to pay me for the things they messed up or just make a note that my performance was not all my fault. So at the very least, it'll be nice that there's a note that the reason I did bad was not all my fault, but I would like if they would pay me the money they owe me, since it is several hundred dollars. So it would easily pay for that 12-string guitar I just bought. So we'll see what happens there, but I'm not gonna stress about it too much. Oh, and another personal thing, music-related, that I'm very excited about is one of my favorite musicians, well, most of my favorite musicians are dead, unfortunately, like Johnny Cash and Pete Seeger and people like that. Almost every musician that I listen to regularly is dead, but of the few musicians that I really like that are alive, there's this mandolin player. Well, he can play basically everything, but mandolin is his main instrument, and his name's Chris Thiele. He's a little bit obscure, so not a ton of people have heard of him, but he plays in two bands. One's called Nickel Creek, and the other's called the Punch Brothers, and I've been obsessed with them since I was in high school. They're very, very good acoustic music. Chris Thiele recently announced, I can't believe I found one iron in this entire place, jeez. Chris Thiele recently announced he's putting on a music camp this summer on Long Island, which is about a 2-hour drive from me. It's a 4-day music camp in a mansion with him and all the members of the Punch Brothers and Nickel Creek and bunch of other acoustic musicians that I really like, that are, not even exaggerating, some of the best musicians in the world, at least for their respective instruments. I really wish I knew what that bar meant when I swing. Anyway, they're putting on a 4-day music camp this summer, and the cost of it is pretty insane. Wow, I didn't realize it's this close to the opening still. It's very, very expensive, so at first I brushed it off as that's way too much money to spend, but I have been saving a decent amount of money these past few months. One, because I was afraid I was going to lose my job, which who knows. Still not impossible to happen with the amount of tech people getting laid off. And also just saving up, because eventually I do want to quit my job again and try to make a living doing music and ASMR videos and photography and just other creative things. So I've been saving up for that, so I do have a decent amount of savings. But I've decided that I'm going to sign up for this camp because it's definitely a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And I can't imagine regretting it, since I've been obsessed with these musicians for over a decade, and they're so good at their craft. Being able to pick their brain for 4 days and perform with them, like it'll be worth it. So I'm very excited for that. that's in July. So I'm trying to make it as cost effective as possible. So I sign up for a couple new credit cards that have $200 cash back bonuses if you spend a certain amount of money. And you can break this thing up into two payments. I'm going to try to put each payment on one credit card to get $400 off. And then they have no interest for 15 months. So I'm just going to pay like $200 a month on them and make it a little less harsh on my finances up front. Very excited for that. So those are some things going on in my life. If any of you have heard of Punch Brothers or Chris Thiele or any of those people, let me know in the comments, because it's few and far between when I meet other people that know them, and they're just such good musicians. It's amazing to see them live. I'm actually seeing Nickel Creek at Pier 17, which is like a rooftop venue on the water in Manhattan. I'm seeing them in May, so I'm excited to see them in May and then to actually get to meet them and perform with them and stuff. And wow, there's a lot of zombies. Let's try to sprint. But yeah, then I get to do all that in July, end of July, early August. I'm a little nervous though, because they always do say not to meet your heroes or whatever, and I've heard not the greatest things about Chris Thiele as a person. So I hope my image of him doesn't get completely ruined and it like ruins my love for his music. But we shall see. Is this another cave or is this just like a little crawl space? Oh shit. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. So loud when they explode. I thought I had those turned down. Well, so now there's some type of fan sound going on outside. I really hope that these sounds are louder for me than they are for you when you listen, because there's just really hard to record in New York without any type of background sounds. There's always something going on. Those musicians, let me know in the comments, because I always love to find another Nickel Creek or Punch Brothers fan. Also, if you play any instruments or a musician or anything, also let me know. I'd love to hear what you play or what type of music you're into. It's not too loud in the background. Wow. Where the heck is the iron in this game? Do I need to go deeper? That's crazy that entire... I mean, I guess it wasn't that big of a cave, but... I would have thought that cave would have more iron in it. Also started watching this show on Amazon Prime with my girlfriend called Daisy Jones and the Six that I'm liking. She read the book that it's based on like a year or so ago and told me that they're making a show, and she was really excited for it. And it's about music and like a fictional music group in like the 60s and 70s. I think we're about halfway through it, but I'm really enjoying it so far. Very much in like a music, I don't even know what to say, music obsession. obsessed state lately. Felt very musically inspired. So yeah, it's nice to be surrounded with all these different music things. I hear a cat. Can I sleep? Okay, it is daytime out now. System across the water. Let's go check that out. Oh yeah, and last week I finally recorded myself. I've recorded a few open mics, but like recorded myself at my apartment playing a few songs. And I need to edit them, and I'll probably do a little more recording. Make them sound a little better, like add some more layers and stuff to them. But I'm excited to create a music YouTube channel and get some of my music out there, because I've been finding the small music channels that I want to engage with them, but I kind of want to have like a calling card myself out there of my music. So I'm excited to edit those videos and upload them. Planning to do that this weekend, but I always plan way too much for the weekend and never get it all done. I also have a lot of music I need to practice. Oh, there's some iron. Plus, hoping to record some more ASMR videos and edit those videos. But yeah, I'm excited to do that. I'm gonna probably keep that separate. Oh, there's an Enderman, that's not good. I'm gonna keep it separate from this channel because, I don't know, I like ASMR, and I probably shouldn't care, but the stigma attached to it, I kinda wanna keep this channel anonymous, so I don't think I will associate it with my music at all, but I'm excited to just get my music out there. Nothing, I haven't written anything. I play like old folk songs and Johnny Cash and things like that. But hopefully I can start networking online with other small musicians that I like. And definitely not trying to like get like a huge YouTube following. I probably won't upload that often. But again, just kind of showing where I'm at and trying to network with other musicians doing a similar thing online. There's this guy from Canada that I like named Jake Valdolin or something like that. I always butcher his last name. I need to actually figure out what his name is and memorize it, but he does kind of old rockabilly type music, and I really like what he's doing, and he still seems to have a fairly small, I hate the pattern of this stuff, it looks like a, in the corner, I thought that was a creeper. Still has a relatively small following. I think he has about 900 subscribers on YouTube. But seems like he's getting more popular. He's won a bunch of music awards in Saskatchewan, Canada, where he's based out of. And I really like what he's doing, so hoping to upload some things. And well, it seems like he's around my age. He might be a little bit younger. But I'd love to try to network with him, so yeah, excited to do that. And then I also need to pack this weekend because I'm going home to see my family, which is a few states away. It's about a 7 or 8 hour drive. I'm going to go home for the next week, and luckily since my job's remote, I can work from there. But I've got some kind of bad news about my grandfather's health. Nothing super bad, but even in general, if it wasn't for that, I do want to go home and see him, and then still have three grandparents that are alive that I'd like to go visit. So I need to get ready for that as well, so I won't be able to record any videos while I'm home. So I need to try to record this weekend to make sure I have plenty of content to upload. Nice, more iron. But it's gonna be a busy few weeks. And then once I get back, my girlfriend's weekends at work change. So right now she has 2 days off in the middle of the week for her weekends. So we never really have a day off together, which sucks, but also for the amount of stuff I try to do with music and ASMR videos and other random little hobbies I have, it's nice to have the weekends to myself to work on stuff. But in April, her weekends switch to Friday, Saturday, so at least we'll have Saturdays off together, which will be nice to finally have a day off together where I don't have to work. But it's also gonna reduce the amount of time I have for all the things I do, so I'm gonna need to adjust to that. So a bit of a double-edged sword, but a lot of exciting things and just changes and being busy for the next few weeks. So luckily I do have a backlog of videos, so there shouldn't be any disruption to that despite all these things. And yeah, if you ever get confused, people that actually watch multiple videos of mine and you're not just watching this one video, definitely uploading things out of order. So some of these Stardew Valley videos and things like that, I probably recorded weeks ago. Is that a sunflower? Don't know where it's going with that, just rambling. Okay, I think my house is over that way, hopefully. I also keep almost like throw this F throw things. F changes hands. When it gets dark in the other game I just recently played. In that game Deep Rock Galactic that I was playing, you press F to throw a flare to light things up, and I keep getting tempted to hit the F button when it gets dark in this game. Okay, I'm not sure where, well, I should go back to my house so I don't die, but I'm not sure where to explore next here. I don't know if I'm just like a huge noob or if this world kinda sucks. I can't remember how to create a mine. Do I just dig straight down? Is that the best way to do it? Yes, I do. I guess my house is built in a cave, so I could just start digging out that mine and hoping I hit something. Excited to go home and see my family, though. The last time I was home was around Christmas. What was that sound? Was that Enderman? Oh, shit. Oh, no. Those aren't good. The drowners, or whatever they're called. Quick swim. I think I stopped playing right around when those got implemented into the game. There's not really any water. I think there are like squids in those things. That was the last time I like really played this. But yeah, I haven't been home for, by the time I go home, it'll be about 4 months. And my family did come and visit me in January, the beginning of January. So it's been a little bit since I've seen them. When I first moved here, I had like 3 weddings. Back in my home state. So I had to go back. I was going back almost every month, which is nice to see everyone, but it sucks to drive 8 hours each way. especially, I don't mind the time as much, I just hate driving in New York. So that part does suck. I could fly, but it'd be way more expensive, and then I wouldn't have a car when I get home, and I usually bring a bunch of instruments and stuff with me, so I wouldn't really be able to pack that on the plane. But I'm excited to see my family and friends next week. That's the sad part of moving away. It's just, I'm very lucky that I still have grandparents that are alive and that I've been so close with my grandparents. I grew up near all of them, basically. One set of grandparents lives like half a mile down the road, so I used to see my grandmother almost every day growing up, which I'm very grateful for. I'd see my grandfather quite often too, but my grandmother would always drop off our mail. So I'd see her every day when she'd do that. And then my other set of grandparents live like half an hour away, so I'd see them pretty often as well. But just as they get older and I make it home less and less, it's just sad knowing that there's only so many more times I'm going to get to see them. Just sad thinking it could be less than 10 realistically. I'll get to see each of them less than 10 more times, which I guess I'm just getting to that age where that's just how life is. So I'm excited that I get to see them next week. Hopefully. You never know what can happen, but I'm excited that I'll most likely get to see them next week. Sorry if that was a little bit dark. Just where I'm at, I guess. Okay, we'll probably do another day or two. I'm at... Oh, it's like, why isn't that working? Almost at the 40-minute mark. Want to make this around an hour. Might be a little less than an hour. Because I'm recording this in the morning, and I do need to start getting ready. Start my actual job. Wish I could do this for my job. This is way more enjoyable, and I feel like I'm, even though I'm not reaching many people, I do feel like this provides way more value than my real job does. That's another thing I think I've noticed. I feel like the less value you actually provide and like the easier job you have, I feel like the more money you make. Like, people that have really hard jobs, like, either just, like, stress-wise, or they're physically hard, or they're just, like, really monotonous and boring. I feel like those jobs don't make that much money. And then when you get kind of a bullshit easy job, like, it's not, like, super easy, not anyone could do it, but it's not coal mining or anything like that, and for my skill set, like, I feel like I have a natural skill set for it. Not that I'm the best salesman, but I think I'm pretty good at it. I don't like the sense of that stuff. But yeah, anyway, I definitely don't have the hardest job, and I feel it's the most money I've ever been making, so I think... like there's an inverse relationship between difficulty of a job and... Oh, we found a cave. Oh, I was saying I hoped I would find a cave, and look at that, we did. Okay, I guess we will make this mine a little bit nicer before we start breaking into it. does anyone else feel like they make so much trash? Like, the amount of trash that my girlfriend and I produce is insane. I feel very bad about it, but I don't know how to stop. Also, not the best about recycling, which I'm not proud to say. We tried to recycle, like, when I was in Maine, or at least when I lived with my parents. I recycle our bottles and stuff, and I do put my balls in recycling, but I guess, I mean, I used to bring them to an actual redemption center. But I feel like that's way harder to do here. I just don't really have anywhere to store our bottles, like back in Maine, where I'm from, obviously, now that I've said that. Save up our bottles for months, and then when we'd have like hundreds of them, we'd bring them back all at once. But here, I don't, like, we'd fill up a refrigerator box and then when it was full, we'd return them. But here, I don't really have room to fill up a refrigerator box, so I just bring individual bags down to the recycling, because I'm not going to bring it to a redemption, like singular bags to a redemption center. But yeah, anyway, I just feel like we make a ton of trash, and I'm like, if everyone is making this much garbage, I have no idea where it's all going. So any tips on how to reduce how much garbage you make, let me know, because it's something that mildly stresses me out pretty irregularly. There's a Pete Seeger, I don't think he wrote it, but he does a song about garbage that I need to sneeze. Okay, I'll cut that out. There's a song Pete Seeger does about garbage. It's not even like, I don't even like the song that much, but there's just a part that goes garbage, garbage, garbage. And every time I'm taking out the garbage now, I get that stuck in my head. Makes me feel bad. Okay. How do you make a glass panel? I make 16 glass panes, okay. Trade. And I wanted to make some doors for the mine. Make them out of acacia wood. On the mine. This looks like a jail cell door. I want to put glass above it, but I guess that wouldn't really make sense. I guess I'll use those glass panes a different time. recording in the morning because I feel like I have way less of those like throat gurgle sounds because I haven't eaten anything yet, and I just feel like I get them more as the day progresses. But it does suck how loud it gets out. Like all these trucks and stuff. And I have to do, well, either way, I guess I need to do a bunch of editing. Because I'm either editing out weird throat sounds, or I'm editing out trucks. So either way, I'm going to be editing a bunch of shit, I guess. But compared to other YouTube videos that people make, I guess it could be a lot worse. That's what I was telling myself when I lost those 5 hours of videos. It was like, at least I was only playing video games. It wasn't some giant production that I spent months on that got messed up. I just played 5 hours of video games and talked to myself for no reason. Okay, I want to put like a little platform down here so I can close the doors down here as well. And hopefully not die in the process. To dig much further to find a mine attached to my house. But hopefully it's actually sizable and full of iron, and some redstone wouldn't be bad either. Out a little bit. Okay, I'll put some doors there and put some glass around them. Try to see some iron back there. God, the scroll wheel on this mouse sucks. Okay, I thought I saw some iron on this wall, but I guess my mind was just playing tricks on me. Monster sounds coming from them. Okay, well, we'll put the doors down and then we'll just start digging this out, I guess. Those are not in the right place, but whatever. Some chest down. with me. Don't know what I'll use it for, but can keep some down at the bottom of the mine. There's an idea, I'm stealing from another ASMR channel, but I really liked it. But they had like a book, like a Minecraft book. Ah, shit. That looks stupid. Fucking, you can't pick glass back up. Like writing fun facts in it and reading them, and I thought that was a cool video because I do like the sounds of keyboard clacking, but there's a difference between just like moving around on the keyboard in a game and typing, and it seemed like a cool way to type. It's got like a really weird feeling in my stomach, like just start feeling ill, like cold chills almost. Oh, that does not feel good. I feel like nauseous all of a sudden. But I'm so close to an hour. I'm gonna push through for 5 more minutes and then probably end this video. Hope I'm not getting sick. My girlfriend's mom was kind of sick towards the end of the trip, so I really hope I did not catch that at the tail end. But yeah, if you'd like a video of me typing in Minecraft, let me know. I might make it anyway, eventually. But if typing on a mechanical keyboard is a trigger for you, let me know. It'll make me more likely to make that video. Oh God, I hope that this feeling passes. Obviously feeling nauseous doesn't feel good, but I have a lot of work to get done today, and I also want to practice a decent amount of music, which... phone on the floor. It fell out of my pocket. That was loud. This video's going downhill fast at the end. Hopefully you're already asleep by this time. Silence, but I'm unfortunately not feeling well at all of a sudden. So I'm just gonna wrap it up here, close enough to an hour. Sorry it's ending like this, but again, if you liked it, please like and subscribe.